Hello friends! If you've been watching my brush review videos, you'll know that I always do a quick stroke test to see how the brush looks at different sizes, and I always mention the size of the canvas that I'm using. In this video, I'm going to show you why the canvas size matters, and how you can adjust the look of your brush with a quick and easy change in the Brush Studio. Let's first take a look at canvas sizes. The main point to remember here is that the size of your canvas makes a difference in how the brush appears. Now, this isn't rocket science, but it's something that new Procreate users often overlook, and it can have an impact on the result you get when using a particular brush. Let's take a look at the dry ink brush, for example. This is one of my favorite brushes. If you've taken any of my classes or workshops in the past few years, you'll know how much I use this brush. And by the way, if you want me to do a full review video on this brush, just let me know in the comments. First, I'm going to start with a small canvas set to 1000 pixels square at 300 dpi. And I'm going to draw three test strokes, starting at a really small size of 2%. Then I'll bump the size up to 25%, and finally 100%. Now I'm going to create a much larger canvas set to 3000 pixels square, still at 300 dpi, because that'll give us a good high quality image. And when I draw the same stroke sizes, starting at 2%, then 25%, and 100%, you can see that even though I'm using the same three sizes, the strokes appear a little bit different on a canvas this large. Here's a side-by-side comparison. On the large canvas, the smallest stroke seems even smaller and you don't see any texture at all. At 25%, the texture is much more obvious on the smaller canvas, while those specks aren't very visible on the large canvas. And then at 100%, the stroke appears much larger and more chunky, and you get even more of that texture on the small canvas compared to the larger canvas. And these differences can affect your drawing experience with the brush. For example, let's say I'm working on the small canvas and I draw a shape and I need to fill it with color. With the brush set to its largest size, I can fill the shape pretty quickly and it maintains all that lovely texture. On the other hand, if I'm working on the large canvas, even with the brush size set to 100%, it takes a lot more work to fill that shape because the stroke size is much smaller and the texture is not very prominent at all. Now, if you're just drawing for fun, none of this is really an issue. But if you need to work on large, high-resolution files, this can become a real limitation. Fortunately, you can resolve this by adjusting a couple simple settings in the Brush Studio. Before making any changes to a brush, I always recommend that you duplicate the brush first so that you can keep the original intact. So once you're in the brush library and you've found your brush, just swipe left and then tap Duplicate. The number 1 will appear next to the name so that you'll know which is the duplicate. Now tap on that duplicate to open up the Brush Studio, then tap on Properties. Under Brush Behavior, you can change the maximum size by dragging the slider to the right as much as you need to. Now you can play around with it to see what size works best for you. I'm gonna drag this to the max, which is 100%. Now since this is a textured brush, I also want the size of the grain to increase. So if I tap on Grain, under Grain Behavior, there are two options here. In the Moving section, I can increase the scale so that those specks appear larger. I'm going to try setting that to about 50%, and then tap Done, and we can test it to see how it looks. Now, remember, I'm working on the large canvas at 3000 pixels square, and this is what my adjusted brush looks like at 100%. And let's compare that to the original dry ink brush, also set to 100%. As you can see, that's a huge difference. Now, if I switch over to the small canvas and I use that adjusted size, As you can see, it's enormous at 100% at this small canvas size versus the original dry ink brush at 100%, which looks like this. So I feel good about those changes that I made to the brush, and it's pretty clear the difference. You can see by the preview that this is a much larger version, but I still like to edit the name so that I know what changes I've made. So I'm just going to tap on that altered version and go to About This Brush. And right here at the top, if I tap here, I can edit the name. And I usually like to create a name that indicates to me what changes I've made. So I'm going to call this version Dry Ink Extra Large Grain. So now when I look in the brush library, it's pretty clear that this is the original version, and this is the version that I made larger and adjusted the grain. Like with most things, there are exceptions, so keep in mind that this adjustment won't be possible for every brush. For some brushes, the size is already maxed out in the default settings. For example, if I look at the properties for the syrup brush, the maximum size is already at 100%, so there's no wiggle room to make a size adjustment there. Of course, it's not necessary to make this size adjustment for all of your brushes, but if you usually work on very large canvases like I do, it's a helpful workaround, and I've made altered versions for several of my favorite brushes. I made an extra large version of the 6B pencil brush. I just increased the maximum size, and I use this one mainly for my rough sketches. I also maxed out the size of the monoline brush. You can see here it goes way beyond just 100%. And I use this one when I want to erase very large areas very quickly. And I also use it for adding large areas of color, especially when I'm creating a background gradient. And I've also experimented with an extra large version of the Procreate pencil brush to try to mimic the look of a colored pencil drawing. I know the Brush Studio can seem a bit intimidating, but I hope this gives you the confidence to explore and experiment with the settings so you can create your own customized brushes that are perfectly suited for the way you work. Just remember to duplicate the original brush so you always have a backup. If you enjoyed this video, I'd love if you'd give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!